nostrils, all the way down to the pelvic floor. You can keep a little bit of a contraction, a little bit of the Kegel contraction in the pelvic floor all the while, just as a focal point for your breath. Let your arms dangle beside you. And on your next exhalation, let the chin descend towards your belly and let your shoulders, everything, stoop in, just like you're bowing in, and a gesture of surrender. And as you inhale, let your chin begin to sweep up towards your right shoulder, begin to straighten up the spine, look over your right shoulder up towards the ceiling, let the gaze come to the ceiling and cross over to the left side. As you exhale, the left chin down towards the left shoulder, you begin to bow in as your chin sweeps across your chest. Your inhalation begins to move up the right-hand side of this big circle with your head, your neck, and your shoulders. And you exhale down the left side of the circle. And you feel your feet and your legs working a little bit too to support you as you really feel the head and the neck and the spine. The arms are just dangling. The hands are relaxed. The arms, the face, everything is relaxed. These big swirling circles with your hips, with your spine, with your head, your neck, your face, your shoulders. And the next time that you finish your exhalation and you're all bowed in, reverse the direction so that you inhale up the left-hand side of the circle now. Same sets of movements. Notice the full impact of the movements, that they're really getting into your lower back as you bend forward and bow in. And then as you open up, you feel your heart lifting towards the ceiling, towards the heavens, el cielo. And as you fold in again and come across, your arms, your fingers are relaxed. Your chest is opening, shoulder blades on the back, and then bowing in, your shoulder blades come forward, and you're completely bowed in like a bird. So when you finish your next exhalation, finish in the bowed in position with your head bowed forward, your chin maybe resting on your chest, your face completely relaxed. Your fingers are relaxed, breathing these complete yogic breaths. You feel the awkwardness of breathing in this position. There is a constriction as you inhale completely. You feel how your body is compressing the breath. And now placing your hands on your knees and taking a little contraction in your pelvic floor, the next time you inhale, let the full yogic inhalation bring you back up to your neutral position. And relax and breathe, let your eyes close. Notice the warmth in your body from these movements. Now we'll continue with the joints and glands. We've done our five head and neck exercises. We've done Simhasana, the lion pose, and we've also done the switches. Now we'll work in the shoulders specifically. So let the arms dangle. Bring your awareness to your shoulder joints and begin by the smallest, most discreet, most subtle circles of your shoulders. Hardly moving them at all. Just really feel this circular motion in the shoulder joint. Hardly any movement at all, and then gradually make those circles, spirals a little bigger, and begin to explore the range of movement, bringing the shoulders farther forward perhaps, maybe higher towards your ears, maybe more onto your back. Notice how your arms are dangling, and the arms and the hands roll outwards and inwards in this movement. So as you come forward, your arms are rolling in, and as you take your shoulders on the back, your palms and your arms begin to roll outwards. Now let this become a little bigger of a motion. Let it actually get into your spine as well. So you might want to come forward a little bit, lean forward a little bit as you take your shoulders forward, and then as you take them onto that fence rail behind you, really lift your heart, peel your heart open, and then tuck your tail and do that again. So you really feel that wave-like ripple down your spine, and then reverse the direction. However you were doing it before, just reverse that direction. So you may have started in one way and now you're good. You're doing your best to do it in the opposite direction. And finally, wherever you are, come back to your neutral position and place your hands on your knees there. Open your eyes, open your mouth, and move your lips over your teeth like a fish, like a guppy. Open your jaw, wiggle your jaw. Stick out your tongue, make some sounds. Shake your head no. Shake your head yes. Another deep breath. Make them wonder if they're in another room. What are they doing in there? Exhale, inhale again. Yeah, good. All right, nice. Now we continue with that. You'll notice you have a lot of saliva in your mouth. Good sign, means relaxation. Also good sign, means producing lots of enzymes for digestion. Good digestion begins with good mastication, with good chewing of your food. Everybody chews their food 33 times, right?
34.
Good, that's good. At least 33 times each mouthful of food. That way the food will stay in your mouth long enough to really become mixed with saliva. Swami Rama always said, remember your intestines don't have teeth. So good digestion, good bowel movements begin with taking time to eat. Don't just, you know, push it in the mouth and then you're done. Like, eat every bite of food and chew it. Try it sometime. Try it. You'll realize that you can't really have a conversation because you really have to count. You have to, you know, sit there quietly. Don't wash it down with liquid, you know. Drink a little, but don't just inhale the food. Chew it 33 times and then see how you do. You know, I think you'll find that you have very pleasant bowel movements, okay?
Are you saying your mouth is full and you chew it 33 times?
Yeah, like each bite of food. So you take a bite of food and you just chew it 33 times until it's like there's no part, you can't even notice that there's any particles in your mouth anymore.
I've never done that.
Well, try it. And you'll see that first of all, you eat less, which is great.
Yeah.
If you're concerned about not gaining weight or, you know, if that's an issue, you just eat, you'll eat less because it takes a lot longer.
To chew it.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm always the last person. Everybody is like, when I'm sitting eating, it's like everybody else is finished. And I'm embarrassed because they're like ready to go on and have dessert or something. And I'm like, go ahead, you know, I'm just going to sit here and, you know, but you'll be less inclined to have second helpings because it takes longer. And you taste the food, you'll see it's a most beautiful thing. But the best part of it is that your digestion becomes very smooth. And there aren't any complications with that. It's so simple, you know? And yet, it's something that doesn't cost a lot of money and doesn't take expert, you know, to tell us this. So we tend to, well, how valuable is that? You know, it's for free, you know? So But try it. Try it. See. Okay. Let us do some movements for our hands and our arms now. So your fingers are dangling beside you. You're sitting tall, breathing in that yogic fashion, feeling the breath flow from the nostrils to the pelvic floor. And now make some little circles with your fingertips, like you're swirling in the water there. And then go a little deeper swirls with the hands and the wrists. And now begin to swirl the whole arms. Start to get into the shoulders as well. And you can lean forward over your feet like you're gonna dive and reach up towards the ceiling. Open your arms like you're putting your arms over a fence rail. And do that a few times now, some really big movements. So you inhale, open, and then as you begin to exhale, you can round out your back towards your chair. And inhale, up, good, okay, now reverse the directions. So wherever you are, it's like you're doing the butterfly in the swimming pool, and you dive in, and then arms sweep back, and then they come up. You fly through the air, alternately cross your hands as you come in again. Really feel that into your whole back, especially when you have your arms up over you and you're diving in. Round your back like a dolphin, like you're a dolphin, and you're smooth diving. Good, nice, okay, good. And then just come back up to your sitting position. So we're really stretching those muscles along the backside of the body. Okay. Let's do a little massage for the mid-body. So take a fist and gently pummel the lower border of your rib cage, the mid-body there, and then lean forward, put an arm on your knee so that you can reach around behind and get into the kidney region with your pummeling there. Pummel your lower back between the lower part of your rib cage and your pelvis, and get down towards your sacrum behind you there, and then come around onto the hip joints, the flank area, the buttocks, as much as you can get of that area, and then switch sides. And again, pummel. If you lean over to the side a little bit, you can open the space between your ribs. It's always fun. You can hear, and you used to do that as you were a kid. And pummel towards the kidney region as far back as you can reach back there. And then that region between your low rib cage and your pelvis behind you in your sacrum area, the hip joint, the sides, the flanks, as we say, buttocks, and then around onto the thighs there. Good. Very good. Now let's continue work on your right leg from your knee back to your hip joint with that pummeling. So you're purposefully going in a directional fashion. So you're going from your knee towards your hip joint. You're doing the upper surfaces of the thigh, the sides, the outside and inside, and then the lower surface, like your hamstring there. Again, from the back of the knee joint back towards your sit bone. Then massage your knee, massage around the kneecap. Feel all of the little indentations, the outlines of the bone. Get onto the upper portion of your lower leg bones, like your calf and your shin area, right where it comes into the knee joint. Again, kind of rake that area, the joint capsule, with your fingertips, and then stroke from the calf muscle up through the back of the knee and onto the hamstring. I like to put my fingers together like wedge shape and go from the calf muscle up through the knee joint and onto the hamstring there, between those tendons that you can feel on the backside of your knee. And after you've done that, as much as feels good for it, then sit tall with the inhalation, lengthen your spine, take a bit of a rotation towards that right leg, and then fold forward so you're laying your right abdomen on your thigh. Reach down that leg as far as you can. Maybe some people get to the foot, Maybe some people get to the calf, the ankle, and massage that part of the limb that you get to. If you're at the foot, press into the bones and the skin of the foot. If you're at the ankle, feel the textures of the skin. Notice whether it's papery or silky or rough or leathery. Is it rubbery? Is it resistant? And then squeeze the muscles of your lower leg with your hands. Squeeze them to the bone. Release gently. Squeeze, release. Work your way from the ankle up towards the knee. All the while, you're massaging your abdomen, your ascending colon, by the pressure of your belly on the thigh there. So once you've done that for some time, then you stroke the entire limb from wherever you are, up the limb, past the ankle, lower leg, knee, thigh, and hip joint, with the broad surfaces of your hands, like you're putting on a big pair of stockings. And you really want to do this a few times at least. Really press into the limb. You're going against the grain, so to speak, against the forces of gravity, and also against the hair follicles. They all tend to grow down towards the floor, so you're energetically moving the energy up the limb, back into the center towards the heart. This is really good for your lymph massage. You can do this while you're laying on your bed in the morning and stick your legs up in the air, you know, and do that. It's really, really good for you. So do that, you know, several times, and then set that limb aside. And then pause for a moment. Sit tall, eyes closed, and notice the sensation, the qualitative sensation between your right leg and your left leg. You can really feel how there's a lot of energy moving in that right leg right now. But at the same time, you can feel that there is energy in your left leg. You can feel your left leg as a peculiar awareness, because you're aware. You can really feel both legs, but there's something different about that right leg based on the massage and palpations that you just did for it. Okay, now we let ourselves turn our attention to our left leg. So let the breath straighten out your spine. So your inhalation lifts your spine, lengthens your spine. You sit a little taller. Breathe all the way down to your pelvic floor, and then take a little bit of a rotation towards that left leg, and then fold forward, laying your left abdomen on your left thigh. Now you're pressing on your descending colon. So it's great. It's great massage. You're able to work down the leg. Maybe you get to your foot. Maybe this side is a little different than it was on the right side. Wherever you are, begin to palpate, feel the bony structures.